smoke a warm meal. I lock my heart in a cell no one could ever steal. At this point I'm a finite free soul. It's hard to find more. At this point I'm a finite resource. It's hard to find more. When you're dragged down by the weight of misplaced meaning, did I idealize you like I was you?
Welcome to The Edge of Me. I'm LaChaga, but you literally all know me, so you can call me Rachel. I'm so excited to be playing this show for you all tonight. I've curated a set that I love. And a huge shout out to Davenport's for having me. I'm so excited to be playing in this space. I want to shout out Megan, who's on lights and tech. Your bartender, Kanemu, is killing, and your server, Amy. So make sure to tip them kindly and be sweet to them. I have a few more songs for tonight, and if you've, you know, a good chunk of you have been to some of my shows before, so you know I like to keep the vibe sort of dynamic, switching between originals and covers, and I do want to say it's maybe going to be a little bit of like emotional whiplash, but like, you know what, we're just like, it's March, so we might as well do that before we like finally get to summer. So this has sort of been like my thesis statement of the winter, kind of curating this show and coming out of like, even up throughout this week, just a lot of blues and sadness and unexpected changes. And but thankfully, I feel like finally things can look up. Like we can finally, from today, like look up. So that's sort of what this all came from. So this next song is gonna be a cover. And unfortunately, like this is gonna be like probably the only like sexy song, so I'm sorry. I know that's why you came here. But I'm sorry about that. Just like the only one. But it's also a song about irrational yearning, and I've gone pro. So this is One of Your Girls by Troye Sivan.
Everybody wants you, baby. Trademark that face. They're laying down the block to be around you. But baby, I'm first in place.
I'm keeping.
The next song that I have for you is an original. I think some of you heard it at my Golden Diver show last year, but this is a song that I actually wrote like 6 years ago, and then I revamped some of the lyrics. I was kind of looking back on it. It's a song called Models in Manhattan, and it sort of came out of like really intense New York City nightlife when I was like in college and underage. And but like, you know, that's sort of where the song came from. But at its core, it's a song about like vicious comparison and yeah, really focusing on yourself way too much. And it's weird because like I still relate to the song now, which is like unfortunate. Like I don't want to feel that way. But also as a songwriter, it's cool to know that my words from so long ago can like hold longevity. Like that's interesting to me. Don't love feeling the way that the song feels, but you know, it's all right. If anyone, like my original thought process when I wrote it back then was just like, if one person can relate to the way that I feel, then I consider that a success. So that's still how I feel about the song. So this is Models in Manhattan.
Put my high heels on, your glamour suit part of my eye. Makeup dark to match the night. Try to have fun, focus on the drinks. It's with myself that I'll start a fight. My tight black dress lighting up as I dance. and skin, cigarettes and skin. Oh.
Thank you. Now I'd love to call up my wonderful pianist Steven to the stage.
Woo!
Bar. It's all friends here. I wanted to just kind of do a little something I haven't done in like ever, which is kind of do a little theatrical moment. So I'm gonna do a little enactment for you. And I did want to say, you know, I've never performed a Taylor Swift song at any of my shows before. I thought that that would be too predictable of a choice for me. However, this is a safe space and I decided I want to get a little theatery with it. So I wanted to kind of do this song and do a little enactment, and Steven's gonna kill it on the keys. So this is Tolerated by Taylor Swift.
Woo!
Use my best colors for your portrait. I lay the table with the fancy shit. I want you to tolerate it. If it's all in my head, tell me now. Just tell me I've got it wrong somehow. I know my love should be celebrated. Tolerated while you were out building other worlds. Where was I? Where's that man who throw blankets over my barbed wire? I made you my temple, my mural, my sky. And now I'm begging for footnotes in the story of your life. And I'm drawing hearts in the byline. I'm always taking up too much space or time. You assume I'm fine, but what would you do?
Someone in here. Next up, I wanted to continue on with sort of like the theater-y vibes. I haven't kind of been in that part of myself in a while, so what better place to do it? Crazy though that I have felt like that song in like every relationship I've been in. Ooh, that's wild. But you know what's wild though is that I was giving those people like love that should have been celebrated, not tolerated, right? But also I was tolerating their behavior. Yeah. So like we're not gonna do that anymore. That's what I'm learning.
No victim.
Right. We are going to onward and upward, and so that's kind of what brings me to my next point, which is like I'm still hopeful, shockingly, you know, I still have hope. And so this next song is from a musical called They're Playing Our Song, and the song is called I Still Believe in Love. But I did want to take just a second to talk about my really dear friends who actually aren't at the show right now. My friend Mary was supposed to accompany me, and thankfully Stephen was so wonderful jumping in last minute and has been absolutely killing it. Literally saved me in the past like 2 days. But my friend Mary was, we'd been rehearsing for like months, and she was supposed to play piano on the Models of Manhattan song as well, and she'd been so dedicated, and all she wanted to do was like rehearse it and perfect it. But her husband, Daniel, who's another one of my really close friends, unfortunately lost a really dear family member this week. And so they had to emergency travel out of the state. And I just wanted to say give a shout out to Mary for all the work she put into this, even though she's not here. And I also just wanted to dedicate this next song to them, because their marriage and Daniel as a person makes me believe in men and love. And Gemini men, and he really does. He really is just like such a wonderful friend to me, and I also know that that is absolutely because of that's absolutely because of the family that raised him. And so they're going through a really, really hard time right now. And so I just wanted to keep them in all of our thoughts and dedicate this song to them. So this song is for Daniel. Maybe I might get it right this time. content with who I am. So I'm holding out my hand to him once again. At least I know I've made myself a friend. And all my life I've been a dreamer. I'm dreaming dreams that always broke in two. But I still believe in love, and I love believing, and I'll keep on dreaming.
Gotta be honest, y'all, even though I literally like know all of you, it's still nerve-wracking to just be like in the dark on stage, you know. But I have another original for you. I don't know how many of you have heard this. I didn't play this. I wrote this song in October. I like to be personal and confessional in my songwriting, if you haven't gathered that. And sometimes, you know, I wrote this in October, and I kind of think about it being just sort of like a self-fulfilling prophecy. Like, things that I'm saying in it hadn't, like, happened yet, but I knew that they were going to happen.
I know that feeling.
Yeah, you know that feeling. I'm like, oh, I'm just coming out of, like, really instinctual, self-pitying nights. And sometimes I, like, wonder if all of my songs are, like, basically just the same sentiment in different words, which I struggle with. I'm like, oh, I want to, like, make things different. But I also know that it's just how I cope with, like, things that are happening in my life, and I keep writing more and more interesting of melodies, so that's exciting. And the same thing with Models of Manhattan. Like, if one person feels seen by any one lyric, then I'm like, I've done it, I've done my job. So this is a song called Pretty Lies. I touch myself, then immediately cry. I hold my pillow like it's the love of my life. I wake up in the morning feeling strong. By the night, I'm stuck in all the wrong. I'm cursed to be a lover without a lover. I watch all of my friends kiss each other. I wait patiently for my turn. Perhaps I just haven't learned. And maybe I've just lived all my lives, made all my mistakes allotted. Never admit how I feel again. Oh, keeping it in keeps me free. Yeah, they may have touched my sacred body, but they never did know me. Maybe I've just lived all my lives and made all of my mistakes allotted. My mess. coffee, I read my novel, I try to make sense of it, but I can't, and that's okay. Cover for you. Now, this is a song that originally wasn't like going to be in the set list. It's a little like we're going to rock out a little more than I like originally intended for the night. We're going to rock out on my acoustic guitar. And this is a song I heard it in like February and I was like, oof, I wish I had written that. And that's like the feeling as a songwriter when you're like, I wish I had fucking written that. Like, this is like too much that it didn't. It feels like it came out of my brain. And it's also really like a satirical song. So it's funny, but here's the thing, everyone. I briefed Hannah on this earlier, but there's a part in the song where I want to, like, I have this urge to kind of like scream or shriek. Yeah. I don't want to do it alone, so I think that you guys should join me. Is everyone down?
Yeah.
Is everyone down to like just kind of like, did someone like cut you off on the highway today, or like, did you like speak to like a man today? Like any of those things, like could get you like feeling the rage. So I think that like we could just do a little scream. But if you guys like don't do it with me, then I'm gonna feel really awkward. So like, is everyone down? Okay. So it's at the end of the second verse, and it's like, so it's going right into the chorus. It's like perfect timing. And the line is, I know that you'd find a way to find it sexy. And on the word sexy, we're all gonna shriek. Like 1 to 2 seconds. Just like really go for it. No one can see you, right? It's dark, so like really go for it. Because if you don't go for it, I'll be sad and I'll confront everyone individually after that. Okay, so we're feeling good? Okay. Okay, this is a song called Mythologize Me by Liza McLam.
So cautious I was, just a kid, and for what it was worth, well, it wasn't all of the suffering. I thought maybe one day I'd use it in a good way. Isn't it great what I made of it? Still boring, anorexic, brain addled, sympathetic to all who thought me so special and pathetic. I'm just so fucked up, well, you couldn't understand me. Boy in the backseat, won't you mythologize me?
Yeah. That was really fun. Thank you so much. I was scared that you guys weren't going to commit, but you really commit. I'm so happy. Okay. We only have two more tonight. So this next one is also a cover, and it's actually, I've done several shows in Chicago at this point, not like so many, but I've actually never like repeated a cover that I've done on my shows. I've always tried to like keep it different, but today I actually wanted to do a song that I did in my very first show back in February of 2022, just because it felt right for this space. And it's a song that I still so kind of resonate with. So this is Anyone by Demi Lovato.
To my imagination, confided into alcohol. I tried some more. I told secrets till my voice was sore. Tired of empty conversations, cause no one hears me anymore. 100 million stories and 100 million songs. I feel stupid when I sing. Nobody's listening to me. But they always get it wrong. I feel stupid when I pray. Why am I praying anyway? When nobody's listening. Anyone, please send me anyone. Lord, is there anyone? Any, someone. Anyone, please send me anyone. Lord, is there too many times. I just need some more affection, like anything to get me by. 100 million stories and 100 million songs. I feel stupid when I sing. Nobody's listening to me. Nobody's listening. I talk to shooting stars, but they always get it wrong. I feel stupid when I pray. So why the fuck am I praying anyway?
Sweet.
That's what they say. It's good. So I just want to take a second to thank Davenport's for having all of us tonight. It's a really wonderful space. It's really fun. It's a good time. And I expect everyone to get a drink with me afterwards. I want to thank Megan, who's running Tech and Lights. And please, 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 tip your servers and bartender and just enjoy some more drinks after we're done. So this is gonna be the last song of the night and the namesake of the show. Some of you heard me tell this joke at my last show, but some of you didn't, so I'm gonna tell it again. Please laugh again. If I had a nickel for every time a man I was dating here in Chicago moved across the country and just left me here in the Midwest, I would have 2 nickels, which is not a lot of nickels, but like, it's kind of weird that that happened to me twice, right? Like, very similarly, it's kind of strange. But, you know, like, as humans, right, our brains, like, want to find patterns in things. We want to, like, logically understand, like, why things happen. And so when, like, a pattern presents itself, it's hard not to be like, why, like, what did I, you know, like, I'm the common denominator, right? Like, what did I do to have that occur twice? And yeah, that's a challenging place to be, but I think that sort of in the same vibe of like self-fulfilling prophecy, like this song I wrote in July, so like before I knew anything that was gonna happen, but I had just sort of been feeling that way of like, okay, am I not like worth the risks to these people? Am I not worth like any sort of, you know, plan? But I think that the best thing that could possibly come out of that is that I wrote the best song that I think my best song that I've ever written, my favorite song that I've ever written, and the way that I've been feeling for the entire past couple of months. So this, thank you guys so much for being here. I'm really excited to chat and hang out after I'm done, but this is The Edge of Me.
You write about leaving, and I write about being left. So I guess it made sense that you moved back out west, and I'm starving, so I feed myself. Space and vibe.
and it's a Friday and let's have fun. Okay, bye.